So the vintage sunset is a great go-to graphic for t-shirts because it takes up a good space, it adds color, it adds interest, and it's very popular right now. I'm going to show you how to make your own vintage sunset using Affinity Designer, a very quick way that I just learned how to do. I'm going to show you also how to color it so you can have as many vintage sunsets as you need. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to make your own vintage sunsets. And this is gonna be a step-by-step tutorial in Affinity Designer. And you can use Affinity Designer version 1 or version 2. They're gonna work pretty much the same way. The icons just look different. So I'm gonna use some basic stuff in here. This is something I just figured out how to do, and I think it's gonna speed up some time for you to make vintage sunsets if you ever made them before. This is a different way of thinking for vintage sunsets, at least the way I thought of vintage sunsets. So I wanted to share it with you. I think this could be really cool, and you can adjust the different sizes and everything. I'm gonna show you exactly how to do it. And then I'm gonna show you how to color it, how to find colors that work. And if you want to use colors from other places, I'm gonna show you how to bring that in and make swatches inside Affinity Designer. So it's an Affinity Designer tutorial, and I think you're gonna love it. Let's get into Affinity Designer right now. All right, I'm here in Affinity Designer. You can see I have Affinity Designer 2, but don't worry, this will work in Affinity Designer 1. We're not gonna do anything too crazy. So first things first, first step for this vintage sunset is the circle tool or ellipse tool, we call it. Click on here. And then hold down shift while you click and drag. So I'm holding down shift first, click on here, and then drag it like this. That's just gonna make a perfect circle. So you can see the width and the height are gonna be the same. You see that right there? Okay, so we're gonna make it as big as we want. You usually take up the page. My artboard right here is 4,500 by 5,400. You can make it whatever you want, but that's what I use. So I'm gonna put my circle right here. So check on here, make sure the fill color is whatever you want. We're gonna start with one color. I'm gonna just use this gray right here, but take off the stroke. So click on here, you see I only have the fill, right? No stroke. Okay, next step is we're gonna use the crop tool right here. So vector crop tool, click on that, and we're gonna crop this circle just up like this. You can, it doesn't really matter. This is where your first, breakpoint is for the vintage sunset. So it can be this high if you want, it can be this high if you want, it doesn't matter. I'm gonna just do it right here so you can see. So we're gonna be able to adjust that really easy later on. So the next thing you're gonna do, you can see right here in the artboard, I just have the one, sorry. We just have this one right here, right? So this is the artboard, inside it is this one ellipse. What we're gonna do is click on this ellipse, and we're gonna make as many sections of the vintage sunset as we want. I'm gonna do 5, you can do as many as you want. I'm gonna hit Command J, and each time I do that, that's a different section. So hit Command J, you can see right there in the layers, there's a second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one. Okay, so I have 5 now right here, every time I hit Command J. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go on the second one right here, and we're gonna pull these down. So now I'm on the second one, I'm gonna crop this down and then pull this top one down until you see a space. You see that right there? And then pull this one up like this. So this is our second section, and you guessed that we're just gonna repeat this over and over. So the third section down right here, click on it. You can see now it's moved to the top here. We're gonna pull the same thing down, same top down. Now we're gonna pass the second one and move it down like this. Now this can be as big or small as you want. So if you want it to get smaller and smaller each time, you can. If not, you can just do it like that. We're just eyeballing it here. So next one is the fourth one. Click on it again. Sometimes you're gonna have to click on it twice. Click on it until you see this right here. So now it's this fourth one. You can see the frame is right here. So now I can move this down. Okay, you may have to practice that a little bit. We're gonna do it one more time so you can see how you do it. Okay, the last one here, click on it. Anyway, make sure that it's up here. You can also click on here and that will be the first one, and then click on here and that will be the second one. So do that, bring it down like this. All right, so there is your vintage sunset. Now you can adjust and eyeball these Like if you want to make it bigger or smaller, right? There you go, super easy vintage sunset. Now, if you want the vintage sunset to be lower, of course, you can just adjust these. See how you can easily adjust any of these now. And if you want more, you can just add more. I only did 5, but you could do 10 or however many you wanted, right? So there you go. So next thing we want to do is color them. So the easiest thing to do is click on here and you can just pick any color. So click on here, pick any color. I'm just picking random colors here, right? And so if you want to find different colors, I'm going to show you how to do that. So we're going to go to the internet now and we're going to find different things with different colors that we may want to put in here. So there's lots of different places where you can find colors. One that I really like is Coolers, right here. You can see coolers.co. And I've talked about this before, but I really love it. You can make your own color palette or you can explore color palettes that's already there. I'm gonna explore this time, but you can try it out for yourself and do it. I'm just gonna show you how this works. So let's say we want this color palette right here, right? Just to make it easy. Of course, they got tons of color palettes, but let's say we want this one. We click on this right here and we can say export palette. So I'm gonna do that. And then we're gonna just do it as an image right here. And we can title our image, we can say colors. And then we want it as CMYK colors. There we go. And you know, we can put labels on it if we want. We can do other options too, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna hit export. And it's gonna save it to my downloads folder. The next place that I wanna show you where to get color palettes is merch by Amazon. So Amazon Merch On Demand, you can go to your favorite print on demand spot. I'm just gonna go here. This is Pretty Merch Pro Plus. If you have it, you can go to research. If you don't, you can just go on Etsy or Redbubble or wherever you find t-shirts, right? Find a t-shirt that has a really good color palette. So let's go here. We could do this one. This is for Easter. We can click on here and just save this. So I'm gonna do on a Mac, you can do Command-Shift-4 and then we just take a screenshot. Boom. We could also pick another one. Let's do one of these. I saw another one. Oh, how about this one? This has some cool colors. I'm gonna click on here, Command-Shift-4. Take a screenshot. All right, so now we have the coolers and 2 t-shirts. I'm gonna go back into Affinity Designer and I'll show you how to use those colors. All right, so here we're back on Affinity Designer. You can see those are the colors that I picked first. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drag in those coolers palette. I have it right here on my desktop. I'm gonna drag it in, change it back from the frame, the crop tool to this move tool. So we're gonna move it over here. And we can just pick the colors now. So we click on here and we can use our eyedropper and just pick the colors from here. Boom. All right, real simple. That's one way to do it. I'm gonna show you another way. Whoops. Pick this color and then pick that color and do that. Okay, another way that you could do it is to make a swatch palette from the colors that you did. So we're gonna go here to swatches. You can see right here, all the swatches. Now, these are some of the recent colors that I used because I did the eyedropper, but you can use this right here. Click on this. You're gonna go to create palette from image, and then it's gonna ask you to select an image. So we're gonna select image, go to our desktop, pick that colors PNG that we saved, and boom. Look at that, it makes a color palette right here. Now it's right now it's saying 5 colors. You can move this up to 10, although there's not that many colors in this right here. So I'm gonna hit create or preview. You can see more colors here. And then I can hit create and it's gonna make its own color palette right there, see that? And now I can just pick the colors from here if I want to. Boom, boom, and so on. Whoops, I think I moved this too fast, right? There we go. I can pick any of these colors. Really neat, right? So as you imagine, I could also do the same thing with the t-shirts that I found. So let's do the same thing here. Let's go to hamburger menu up here at the top on swatches, pick my create palette from image, select the image that I did the screenshot. Let's do the first one. See, it's making a palette from that t-shirt. Now again, I can do 5, 10, 12, whatever, hit a preview, boom, it makes another color palette, right? So I can just come in here and pick the colors off of here and be good. Easy as that, right? If I want another color palette, I come in here, let's do it one last time. Do that second one that we did. So I'm gonna go pick that second screenshot. Boom, look, all the colors right there. Hit create, now it's right there. So I can just come in here and again, pick the colors that I want from this. Let's say maybe I do pink first or orange and then, you know, the other one and so on. So lots of ways to do this to make color palettes. Again, you can go to coolers, you can pick t-shirts off the internet, find any color palette that you want, and you could do the eyedropper, but again, this is a real quick way to just make swatches here and then click it back and forth. So hopefully that was really helpful for you. You can adjust this vintage sunset as well, like I said. So if you want it taller or bigger, just make sure when you click on it, click on the crop tool. So now that we're here, the crop tool is what you want, right? Move it with the crop tool and you'll be good. Don't try and click on here with the move tool, because if you hit the move tool, you're gonna move the whole thing and then it's gonna get out of balance, right? Because everything, all of these need to be in the same spot for it to work. So don't click the move tool, go to the crop tool right here and then you can move these things, okay? Real easy to do, and you can make this as big or as small as you want, and you can change the colors really easily. If I were you, I would just make a bunch of these, right? So you can come in here, once you do one, let's zoom out. So you can copy the artboard by hitting Option, click on here and drag, hold down Shift to just to make it straight. And then you can make another vintage sunset with different colors and another vintage sunset with different colors. And then I'll use this as your graphics asset. So if you want different vintage sunsets, you can. This is gonna be your go-to with all the different colors. So a little bit of setup in the beginning, but then you'll have a lot of vintage sunsets that you can use anytime you want. So that's how you make a vintage sunset in Affinity Designer, at least one of the ways you do it. I think this way is really the quickest way to adjust the vintage sunset and the colors really easily. And you can see, you can scale this thing and make so many and just have it later on for use for different projects and different holidays and different colors and things like that. So have fun with this. If you want to see another Affinity Designer tutorial, I have this one right here where I make like a rainbow design, a gradient design for your t-shirts. I think that one's really fun too if you haven't seen that one. Thanks again for watching, and as always guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.